Hi folks, John Tobus here. Let's talk about putting a K1, K2, or K3 keyword on an aristocrat. What you're going to want to do is start with an aristocrat. In this case here, I let the test builder give us one, and it gave us a hard K1 aristocrat with a hint. So I want to go ahead and let's go and find us a K1 keyword. Well, you can just simply put a keyword in here. You can put in anything you want, like something as a keyword, as a key phrase. You know, it's challenging. You want to make it so that the keyword is something that they're going to discover after they've solved the entire cipher. So we now have a new feature in here called suggest keyword. So we're going for a K1, and I'm going to say suggest keyword. The system will go out and look for all of the eight, nine, and 10 letter words that have no repeating characters in it in order to make it a little bit easier for you. It does use some European spellings on there, like you can see neighbor there. But Goldsmith is not a bad one. It for a K1, it's going to pick a keyword that all of the letters appear at least once in the plain text of your cipher. And it gives you some choices of offsets. Now, if you want to make it a little bit harder, you want the keyword to wrap across around the end of it. So, for example, I'm going to take combative, and I'm going to use an offset of 19. And if you see, combative comes in here and says combative. You can see that the C starts with a T and then it wraps around the end of it. This makes it a little bit harder. You can change the offset to whatever you want. In this particular case, it'll tell us that, say, you can't use this because U happens to map to U. So you have to find a place where it fits. That's one of the reasons why the suggest keyword is there. It does all the work for you and finds places where there are legal and offers you options. So in this case here, righteous, offset 23 and 19 is certainly going to wrap, but an offset 6, it's going to appear in the middle of it. So that makes it a little bit easier for them to solve or at least use the keyword. Works the same with a K2. So if we go and say, instead of a K1, let's go and do a K2. And you'll notice the question text says, we're not saying it's a K2 because we had a K1 in here, but I can make it a K2. Suggest a keyword. K2 is a little bit harder. In order to find something that maps all the way, particularly if you want something that is offset over the end of the alphabet. The reason why is with a K2, in order for all of the letters to map, you need to make sure that all the letters of the keyword occur in order in the alphabet, because the K2 replacement alphabet is in alphabetical order. And very frequently, you don't have a J or a Q, which means that the longest keyword you could have that will fit in there without, you know, since the J and the Q aren't mapped, is going to be 8 or 9 characters. This takes this into account. That's why you see the yellow one that says, all right, with a yellow one, an offset of 4 or 5, or let's see here, let's presumably with an offset of 11. Now that we pick presumably with an offset 11, you can see that it appears down in the replacement text, the presumably, right above the letters L, M, N, all the way through U. Now, as it turns out, remember it was in yellow. If we had picked one that was in blue, then all the letters would be mapped. In this case, it's yellow, so one of the letters is not mapped. Well, let's just color it so we can see which ones are the mapping. As you can see in this case, the letters J, P, W, X, and Z do not occur in the plain text. You can see that unlocking some secrets of the universe needs thinking in terms of energy frequency. Well, there's a Q. So, you know, Q is one of the uncommon ones. It happens to be in here, but J does not exist anywhere. And how do we know that? By looking at things. Well, you can see the J, which was X maps to J, and it tells you, if you look over here for the X, there's no X is found. Same thing with the U maps to P, and the letter U, there are no U's found. So, but this gives you that idea. So if you take the blue ones, it guarantees when they solve it, they will see all the letters of the keyword. When you take the yellow ones, it means all but one of them will be, and it's generally pretty obvious what that last missing letter is, particularly if you got a keyword of Egyptian and use that. K3 is a little bit different. With a K3, it's going to give you an offset of 1, 2, or 3. And the reason why is we want them to be able to figure out the keyword, and a K3 requires them shifting the letters of the alphabet. With a small offset of 1, 2, or 3, a K3 is a lot easier for them to figure out what the keyword is. But And by the way, if you don't like the keyword shows, you can click regenerate and you'll keep finding others. Oh, lumberjack, that's not a bad one. But in this case here, we go back to our K1. We can suggest a keyword. Certainly with an offset of 17 looks like a good one. Now that we've gotten that in there, we can say, all right, let's suggest what the question text would be. All right, so we're going to replace that. And then we're also going to say, how many points is it going to be? It's suggesting, based on all that, 240 points. We set it, and now we've done our K1 aristocrat. Hopefully this is helpful to you. Have a wonderful day.